come. Blessed are the dead which die in the Lord. From henceforth, yea, saith the Spirit, that they may rest from their labors, and their works do follow them. The processional of our presiding bishop and general board, and College of Bishops, the Church of God in Christ, has come to Memphis today to celebrate the life, work, and ministry of Mother Louise Dowdy Patterson. His Grace, the Most Reverend John Drew Sheard, presiding bishop, chief apostle, is the chief celebrant. The Right Reverend Brandon Burdett Porter, Sr., Memphis, Tennessee, Secretary to the General Board. The Right Reverend Michael Eugene Hill, Sr., Assistant Secretary for the General Board, Detroit, Michigan. The Right Reverend Daryl Lynn Hines, Senior General Board Member. The Right Reverend Prince Earl William Bryant, Senior, Houston, Texas. The Right Reverend David Allen Hall, Sr., Memphis, Tennessee. The Right Reverend Malcolm Winslow Kobe, Oklahoma City, Oklahoma. The Right Reverend Charles Henry McClellan, General Board Member, Detroit, Michigan, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. The Right Reverend Elijah Hosea Henderson III, the Chairman of our General Assembly. The Right Reverend Lemuel F. Houston, the General Secretary of the Church. The Bishop J. Harley Lyles. The College of Bishops from around the country have joined us today, led by our chairman, Bishop Galbraith. Thank you. just received the family of Mother Patterson. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. And yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. And surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress. My God, in him will I trust. Surely he shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. He shall cover thee with his feathers, and under his wings shalt thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler. Thou shalt not be afraid of the terror by night, nor of the arrow that fleeth by day, nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor for the destruction that wasteth at noonday. 1,000 shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come nigh thee.
Oh,
Only with thine eyes shalt thou behold and see the reward of the wicked. Because thou hast made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, thy inhabitation. There shall no evil befall thee, neither shall any plague come nigh thy dwelling. For he shall give his angels charge over thee, to keep thee in all thy ways. They shall bear thee up with his hands, lest thou dash thy foot against a stone. Thou shalt tread upon the lion and adder, the young lion and the dragon shalt thou trample under feet. Because he hath set his love upon me, therefore will I deliver him. I will set him on high, because thou hast known my name. He shall call me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him with long life. Will I satisfy him and show him my salvation? going to ask that there be no picture taking of the remains. Please don't do that. And if our adjutant brothers will follow them back to their seats regarding that photograph. National Adjutancy will now prepare to seal the coffin.
Thank you.
put our hands together and celebrate the Lord. We have come to celebrate today. Oh, I believe you can do a lot better than that with the clapping of your hands and giving the Lord praise and giving unto him thanks. Our worship leader for today's service is the Right Reverend Dale Lynn Hines, Sr., General Board Member, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Receive him.
David said, O God, thou art my God. Early will I seek thee, my soul thirsts for thee, my flesh longeth for thee in a dry and thirsty land, where no water is, because thy loving kindness is better than life. My lips shall praise thee. Is there anybody right here today that can give God a praise because he's good anyhow? He's a good God in the midst of it all. We bless the Lord, and what a joy it is for us to be together today. There's so much I could say, but because I'm asked to share in this capacity, I will just say I thank God that she considered me a son, my wife and I, as spiritual children, and I will never forget her. We're going to go through the program today, and I'm going to ask that as you come to make your remarks, we appreciate your kindness, and we also appreciate your consideration that your remarks are to be kept to 2 minutes. Please consider that as you're speaking, so start now figuring out how you're going to make your 2-minute remark. So when you come up, you can do that for us and honor the family's request. We appreciate that. At this time, we will have the hymn of comfort, I Know Who Holds Tomorrow. And then we will have the prayer of comfort from the Right Reverend Prince E.W. Bryant, Sr., General Board Member, Houston, Texas. Then we will have the Old Testament scripture, Proverbs 31, 10 through 30, from the Right Reverend David A. Hall, Sr., General Board Member, Memphis, Tennessee. And then the Hallelujah chant from the C.H. Mason Memorial Choir. And then the New Testament scripture, 1 Corinthians 5, 1 and 8, from the Right Reverend Charles H. McClellan, General Board Member, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. And then we will have the Ministry of Music of the C.H. Mason Choir in that order. Thank you.
I don't know about tomorrow. I just live from day to day. I don't borrow from the sunshine, for the clouds may turn to gray. I don't worry for the future, and today I'll walk beside him, for he knows what lies ahead. Many things about tomorrow I don't seem to understand. Is getting brighter as the golden stairs I climb. Every burden's getting lighter. Every cloud is silver lined. The sun is always shining. There's no tears will dim the eye. At the ending of the rainbow, where the mountains touch the sky, many things
My soul say yes. 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 Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, to your will. 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 Heads bowed and hearts reverenced. Our Father and our God, and our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the great shepherd of the sheep and the soon coming King. Thou who art over us, and thou who art with us, and thou who art one of us. We acknowledge your sovereignty. You rule and you super rule. You reign supreme today in the earth realm. You are holy God, the author of life and the creator of all things. We celebrate your omnipotence because all power is in your hand. Your omniscience, God, you know all things. You are omnipresent, and that means that you're present here right now. You are Emmanuel, God with us. Be with us now. You're good God. You're God of love and compassion. You're merciful and faithful. You're just. You alone are worthy of our praise and to receive honor. The only wise God, our Savior, our help, our rock, our deliverer, our strength, our horn of salvation. Thank you, Jesus. You are a comforter today. Be who you are. Be our comforter. The comforter. Comfort this family right now with your arms of strength and your arms of power. And then, Lord, we thank you for your grace, amazing grace, how sweet the sound. Save a wretch like me. Thank you for your unconditional love. You love us now. Even in this service of comfort and celebration, we feel your love. Help us to feel your love. Move among us. Forgive us of our wrong. Forgive us of our sins. You said in your word, if we would confess our sins, that you would be just and faithful to forgive us of all of our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. And then, Lord, today we thank you. We thank you for our presiding bishop, our chief apostle, the general board, the board of bishops. We thank you for the church of God in Christ. And then most of all today, we thank you for this righteous and godly, priestly, and apostolic family that sit here today. We thank you for Mother Louise today. We thank you for her grace. We thank you for her style. We thank you for her elegance. We thank you for her love. We thank you, O God, for this entire family. Now bless us today. Bless this service of celebration. We invite your presence. Come in now. We need you right now. Come in. Descend upon this service as you descend with the Shekinah glory cloud upon Mount Sinai. Be here now. Be our strength. Be our courage and be our joy. These blessings and favors we ask in Jesus' name. Amen.
the Word of God from the old book, Proverbs 31, verses 10 through 30, in your hearing. Who can find a virtuous woman? For her price is far above rubies. The heart of her husband doth safely trust in her, so that he shall have no need of spoil. She will do him good and not evil all the days of her life. She seeketh wool and flax, and worketh willingly with her hands. She is like the merchant's ship. She bringeth her food from afar. She riseth also while it is yet night, and giveth meat to her household, and a portion to her maidens. She considereth a field, and buyeth it. With the fruit of her hand she planteth a vineyard. She girdeth her loins with strength, and strengtheneth her arms. She perceiveth that the merchandise is good. Her candle goeth not out by night. She layeth her hands on the spindle, and her hands hold the distaff. She stretcheth out her hand to the poor, yea, she reacheth forth her hands to the needy. She is not afraid of the snow. For all her household shall are clothed with scarlet. She maketh herself covering of tapestry. Her clothing is silk and purple. Her husband is known in the gates, while he sitteth among the elders of the land. She maketh fine linen and selleth it, and delivereth girdles unto the merchant. Strength and honor are her clothing, and she shall rejoice in time to come. She openeth her mouth with wisdom, and in her tongue is the law of kindness. She looketh well to the ways of her household, and eateth not the bread of idleness. Her children rise up and call her blessed, her husband also, and he praises her. Many daughters have done virtually, but thou excelleth them all. Favor is deceitful and beauty is vain, but the woman that feareth the Lord, she shall be praised, and his word is blessed. Amen.
Book of 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verses 1 through 8. For we know that if our earthly house of this tabernacle were dissolved, we have a building of God, a house not made with hands, eternal in the heavens. For in this we groan, earnestly desiring to be clothed upon with our house which is from heaven. If so be that being clothed we shall not be found naked. We that are in this tabernacle do groan, being burdened, not for that we would be unclothed, but clothed upon, that mortality might be swallowed up of life. Now he that hath wrought us for the selfsame thing is God, who also hath given unto us the earnest of the Spirit. Therefore we are always confident, knowing that whilst we are at home in the body, we are absent from the Lord. For we walk by faith, not by sight. We are confident, I say, and willing rather to be absent from the body and to be present with the Lord. This is the word of the Lord.
Praise God. Oh,
Before you take your seats, look at somebody and tell them, can't nobody do me like Jesus. Somebody didn't look at nobody. Look at somebody else and say, can't nobody do me like Jesus. Now give him another hand praise, everybody. Come on, let's give him a hand praise. He deserves a hand praise. Come on, let's give it to him. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Yes. God has been. Hey. I think we can take a moment and give God some praise. Come on, y'all, just praise him for a moment. Everybody, if you got to dance, put it in right there. If you got to clap, put it in right there. Let's give God praise just for a few moments. He's worthy. With me.
To God be the glory.
Everybody.
To God be the glory.
Lift your voice.
To God be the glory for the things he's done. For the things he's done. For the things he's done. For the things.
Come on, one more time, everybody.
To God be the glory. To God be the glory. To God be the glory. For the things he's done. For the things he's done. For the things he's done. For all the things he's done. To God be the glory. To God be the glory. To God be the glory. For the things
God bless you. Please take your seats in the presence of the Lord. We appreciate the praise. It's always appropriate to give praise to God, especially when you're celebrating a saint of God like Mother Louise Patterson. I called her Mom Patterson. She told me, don't call me Mother, call me Mom. So I called her Mom Patterson. But we so appreciate and thank God for our presiding bishop. We want to honor him, Bishop J. Drew Sheard. And to all the general board, we want to thank God for Supervisor of Women, Mother McCoo Lewis. God bless you. And we also have the elected officials who you'll be hearing from in just a moment. Thank God for our board of bishops that are here. God bless you. And also the ecumenical board of bishops that have joined us. Thank you for being a part of this celebration of life. Mother Patterson was a rich lady. She was rich enough to leave all of us something. All of us. As a matter of fact, I got a couple pair of shoes she gave me from Bishop Patterson, some neckties, but there's some personal things she gave me. And the first thing was she gave me some memory. I can remember how good God was to her and how she treated me like a natural son. She left me and my wife influence. There are things that she has shared with me that literally matured me and changed my life. And last but not least, she left me a witness. The Bible says we are so compassed about by so great a cloud of witness. She left all of us and we can celebrate God for that. Let's do that right now. If you don't have a paper program, you're encouraged to go to the website of the Church of God in Christ. There is a QR code that you can go to, and it will bring you the, it'll download the program to your device. We want to, again, move with the service, and we're going to ask again that we keep our remarks and our love responses. We know we could say a lot of things, but 2 minutes, we thank you for doing that. I'm going to have and ask a friend and brother of mine, the Reverend Wright Frank A. White, Financial Secretary, Freeport, New York, to come in a moment. Following him, we will have, we will have expressions from Mother Vanessa Winbush Gatlin, the Second Assistant General Supervisor, the International Department of Women, Lafayette, Louisiana. And immediately following her, we will hear from the Right Reverend Frank A. White, Financial Secretary, Freeport, Illinois. In that order. Let's say amen for them as they come.
When your assignments are completed, hand in your completed test and receive your reward. To be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. So we give exclusive glory today to my Lord and Savior, our Chief Apostle and Presiding Bishop J. Drew Sheard, the General Board and the entire Presidium of our church, our Sainted General Supervisor, Mother Barbara McCool Lewis, the fragrance of our church, First Lady Karen Clark Sheard, the Board of Bishops, the Bishops' Wives, Supervisors, and all of my sisters and brothers. I'm grateful for this esteemed privilege to express words on behalf of the one and only holy, gracious, beautiful, loving, graceful, and stylish Mother Louise Dowdy Patterson. Our casual relationship changed to a more intimate one about 20 years ago. For some reason, I was one of the ones she chose. For my inaugural celebration dinner, Mother Rivers had an emergency at the last moment. Mother Patterson, who was already scheduled to attend, I asked her, and she immediately said, "Oh no, I can't do that." But then she accepted the invite and turned the place out with her hand on her hip as only she could, speaking prolifically to everyone. This cemented our relationship and took it to another level. Today, we celebrate a woman who was full of grace, poise, and dignity, not arrogant, but assured in who and whom she was. We celebrate her courageous spirit and tenacity to work her assignments. As I have read and spoken to others, her assignments span the nation from coast to coast. Everyone is aware of her public assignment, where she has kept us inspired and encouraged by the Bountiful Blessings Ministry. And thank God for those messages that are continuing to speak life and hope to millions. But her private assignment, where she nurtured those of us that she birthed through love and chosen by God, to receive constant impartation, encouragement, wisdom, and stern instructions when needed. She never complained, but constantly sought to hold up the bloodstained banner. I can see her now entering in, looking like she just stepped off of the Paris fashion runway, giving the saints a live example of holiness, personified by the epitome of femininity. Though many days she suffered pains in her body, She pressed through with great diligence, working her two assignments, public and private. She had a thorough understanding of the word, having been a Sunday school teacher, that what she did in secret would be rewarded openly. I have engaged the Apostle Paul to help me with a vivid and concise view of Mother Patterson. In Philippians 3, 13 and 14, brethren, I count not myself to have apprehended, but this one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forth into those things which are before, I press toward the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. First, Mother didn't live in regret, but forgot the past to reach to the greater destiny she knew was before her. And secondly, she understood that this was a pressing way. So she pressed diligently through the vicissitudes of life, through many dangerous toils and snares was her testimony, but still she pressed on. Mother pressed through amidst distractions which sometimes posed great difficulty. It was all in the Master's plan that the bruising and crushing would produce quality oil from her life. At times being unappreciated, unloved, abused, taken for granted, but she pressed on toward the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. Mother Patterson, as only you could say, Nessa, as you gave those of us that talk to you all of the time instructions, we've heard you and we will obey. But now I say to you, you've pressed all the way to your completed assignments. The many things you did in secret as well in public have pushed you to the finish line. Receive your reward. Well done, thy good and faithful servant. Enter into the joy of the Lord. May your example of completed assignments encourage us today to continue pressing. Mother Kelly, Brother Ron, entire family, let's live so we can see her again. Kay, be encouraged and remember all of the great lessons she taught you. Know for a fact that God will not forget your labor of love. Rest, my love, and we'll meet again in that great reunion around God's throne. Remember, when your assignments are completed, hand in your completed test and receive your reward.
Beams of heaven as I go through this wilderness below. Guide my feet through peaceful ways, turn my midnight into day. I do not know how long 'twill be or what the future holds for me. But this I know, if Jesus leads me, I shall get home someday. Chief Apostle and Presiding Bishop, this expression of remembrance is indicative of your kindness and love, and may I say thank you. The seasons of our lives are filled with godly influences. I am forever grateful for the divine providence of God showered upon my life with the favor, the intimacy, the personal touch of Bishop G.E. Patterson and Mother Louise Patterson. As I stand before you today, my heart is filled with precious memories. It was 15 years ago that one of the greatest honors of my life was to eulogize her husband. And I said to her, as I was with your husband, I will be with you. I saw her for the last 15 years do everything within the fiber of her being to keep the legacy, the memory, and the ministry vibrant. And what a magnificent task she did. I can still hear her singing, I shall never let go of his hand. And for more than 80 amazing years, she was determined never to let go of the legacy that God gave to her. Indeed, we're all familiar with the great words of the King. King, as he reminisced the life of his dear mother, all the wonderful sage advice that she gave to him, and he later arranged it in poetic form and recorded it for the ages that we heard earlier today. Who can find a virtuous woman? Well, it's impossible to contemplate virtue and not think of Mother Louise Patterson. Indeed, Mother Patterson's virtue was simply magnificent. Her words were always seasoned with grace, and her maternal affection was warm. Her faith was unshakable, and her prayer life was steadfast. Her discernment was impeccable, and her wisdom was priceless. Her countenance was brilliant, and her wardrobe was meticulously cosmopolitan. Her style was sophisticated, and her strut was perfectly elegant. Her disposition was refined, and her presence was captivating. Her inner strength was phenomenal, and her ladyhood was quintessential. Her demeanor was poised, and her generosity was unlimited. Her hospitality was genuine, and her smile was infectious. Her laugh was contagious. Her voice was so refreshing. Her ministry of song was anointed. Her teaching was always encouraging. Her spirit was uplifting. Her grace was stunning. Her testimony was sanctified. Her witness was glorious. Her journey was victorious. Her pilgrimage was extraordinary. Her life was inspiring. Her touch was enduring. Her departure was precious. And as I arrived at the convocation just 2 weeks ago, my phone rang, and Mama called me and said, son, Mama, how are you? I'm in the hospital. And she said, Kay, my big sis, whom we affectionately have those titles, tell Anthon where I am so he can come here right away. Parenthetically, may I say, big sis, you have served the Patterson family extremely well. Let's salute this precious dear lady of the Lord. 49 years of your life in service. I made a few trips, and my last trip, as I go to my seat upon my departure of this city, went into the hospital room, held Mama's hand, kissed her on the forehead, and said, I love you. And she said, son, I want to go home. And today, Mama is home. No more pain, no more tears. Beloved family, I leave you with the words of our Lord Jesus. I will not leave you comfortless. Thank God for the Holy Ghost. His presence is with you. Thank you.
Is a dear friend of the family, Bishop Marvin L. Winans. Will you receive him at this time? God, we give honor to God, giving honor to our presiding bishop, to the First Lady, Karen, to all of the board of bishops, to this family. Bishop Anthon said it all. I would just call her, and maybe about 3 or 4 weeks ago, I don't know, I just felt like talking to her, and I called her, and I know she's mother, evangelist, Louise D. Patterson, but I would just call her Wheezy. And whenever I call, I said, Wheezy? She said, oh, this must be Marvin. And we just had a wonderful conversation. I would always tell Pastor Donnie that she loved me more. And so we would argue over who would, you know, I said, you know I love you more, Wheezy. She said, I don't know. She just putting us against each other, but Pastor Donnie had to be in Africa. He's in Nigeria, so I guess I'm here, so what can I say? I'm just, you know, I just praise God on behalf of my family, my mother, my wife, my brothers and sisters. We just loved Bishop Gilbert Earl. We called him Uncle Gil, and we called Mama Wheezy, and just that's all I'll say. All right. They asked me to sing something.
Yes, sir.
Here we go. Let's go. You can clap your hands. This ain't a concert. A little song we did. The old song said, what do you want the Lord to say? What do you want the Lord to say? Want to hear him say, well, enter in the joy of the Lord. Help me sing now. What do you want the Lord to say? Just a little while to stay here. Just a little while to wait. Oh, it's just a little while to labor in the path that's always straight. Then it's just a little more of trouble. Oh, in this low and sinful state. And then we'll enter heaven's water. We'll go sweeping through those pearly gates. Help me say, just a little while to stay. Help me just a little while. You remember the saints used to sing that said, just a little while to labor in the path that's always straight. They say it's just a little more, my God, a trouble. Oh, then we'll enter heaven's portal, and we'll go on and they be talking about heaven. Hallelujah. And then the mother would get up and say this, after a while it'll all be over. After a while the sun will shine. After a while dark clouds will pass over. And we'll shout hallelujah after a while.
Good and faithful servant. As we move further in our service, we do thank God for our presiding Bishop J. Drew Sheard is going to come and minister a great powerful word as our eulogist. And so I'm going to ask again if you would be mindful. It's just as difficult for me to have to ask you as it is for you to try and do it. But I'm going to ask that you would please keep your response and remarks to 2 minutes. And I appreciate you all for at least trying. I won't be in trouble if you try. We want to thank God for the national tributes that we're about to have present. We want to thank God for the International Department of Women, Mother Barbara McCool Lewis, who is the General Supervisor, the International Department of Women from Los Angeles, California. She will come. Following her will be the General Assembly, the Right Reverend Lemuel F. Houston, the Chairman of the General Assembly, Kansas City, Kansas. And quickly behind him will be the General Board Member, the Right Reverend Brandon B. Porter, Sr., the Secretary of the General Board, Memphis, Tennessee. And then representing the General Church will be the Right Reverend Joel H. Lyles, Jr., the General Secretary from Baltimore, Maryland. And then we will have the Ministry of Music from the C.H. Mason Memorial Choir. Thank you again for allowing me to be consistent with that 2 minutes.
To our presiding bishop and chief apostle, Bishop John Drew Sheard, to members of the general board, the entire leadership of our church, to our first lady, Lady Karen Clark Sheard, I will ask that Mother Gatlin will come and stand with me, please. Certainly to all of the supervisors and beloved bishops' wives, who are here on today. To beloved Mother Frances Kelly, God bless her. To precious Kay, to the entire Dowdy and Patterson family, precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his saints. It is impossible to describe Mother Louise Patterson without adjectives such as class, grace, refine, poise, unique, elegant, a regal lady full of wisdom with a love for God and his people. She had a powerful anointing to inspire and motivate men and women alike, an iconic role model for pastors' wives, bishops' wives, and women at every level. Strength and honor were her clothing. Wife of the sixth in succession, presiding Bishop Gilbert Earl Patterson. She was a licensed evangelist missionary who was graced with a charisma to fearlessly convey the gospel message, and an active member of the bishop's wives. From the days of Mother Maddie McLaughlin, Mother Emma Crouch, Mother Willie Mae Rivers, and yours truly, she was always there, always faithful and dedicated to the work of the women. The tenure of Bishop Patterson Before the tenure of Bishop Patterson, she was assigned by Mother Crouch to be the announcer during our Women's International Convention. Being from California, I love to hear Mother Louise Patterson with that Tennessee dialect. An astute woman who developed business prowess, committed to preserving the legacy of her beloved husband. Founder of the Total Woman's Conference, President and CEO of Bountiful Blessings Incorporated, General Manager of radio station WBBP, President of Podium Records, and a published author. I met Mother Patterson personally during the Holy Convocation in Southern California in 1988. It was my first year as a new and nervous jurisdictional supervisor. Bishop Blake had invited Bishop Patterson to be one of our convocation speakers. She was exceptionally kind and conversed with me as if she had known me for years. From there began a friendship with visits to their home while in Memphis and in frequent conversations. She called me a few days before our state women's convention in California in 2005 and said, "I want to come to your women's convention." Needless to say, I was delighted and a bit uneasy all at the same time to have, yes, the presiding bishop's wife and truly a friend. She came and participated in every aspect of our convention and was an absolute blessing to all of us. One of my first telephone calls when I became the general mother in 2017 came with words of strength and encouragement from Lady Lou. Mother Patterson stood tall among God's chosen. Her beauty extended far beyond the flawless, impeccable royal attire. She possessed a passion, love, and protectiveness for the vulnerable and those who needed a voice. Her presentation to the world was a reflection of her internal priceless grace. She had a service to our dear Mother Frances Kelly. Two powerful sisters, what a beautiful relationship you and Mother Patterson displayed to the saints. Her assignment here on earth has come to an end. But Mother Kelly, the Lord has so much more for you. To the daughter, Kay, thank you for that daughter's love and the care you shared for beloved Mother Louise Patterson. Always by her side, always attentive to her needs. Jean and Dean, God bless you for your dedicated life to this mighty woman of God. To the entire biological and spiritual family of this woman of God, on behalf of the International Department of Women, we offer our love, continued prayers, and our availability to you in these coming weeks and months. During those special times of tears and grief, lift up your eyes to the hills from whence cometh your help. Your help comes from the Lord. He can be touched with the feelings of our infirmities. A love token has been mailed, Mother Kelly, to your home. A love token has been mailed to you, Lady Kay. I ask that Supervisor Renee Murray will present the resolution to the family from the International Department of Women and from the widowed bishop's wives, Mother Cheryl Lee. I also have a love token for Lady Kay and Mother Kelly from our Supervisor Emerita, Mother Willie Mae Rivers. Well, she and Bishop are together again, and so today we give her of the fruit of her hands and her own works, pleasure at the gate. God bless you.
My expression will probably be the closest to 2 minutes of any, but that in no way is indicative of any diminishing of love or respect, because the General Assembly, like all of you, loved Mother Louise Patterson. Why don't we praise the Lord for her life? Bishop Wells just gave me a helpful reminder for you, 2 minutes. I don't care how many seconds you may have left in your life, seize this one. If you are a believer, to lift your hand and shout, I am a believer. This could have been a private family memorial. This could have been a local service only for Temple of Deliverance. This could have been the final fitting tribute presented by the fourth jurisdiction of Tennessee. But I'd like to appreciate our presiding bishop and general board for allowing this to be a national funeral for the entire church. I think we ought to appreciate Bishop Sherrod and the leadership of the church. Mother Patterson was a frequent and faithful delegate to the General Assembly. When she was a new jurisdictional bishop's wife, she was present. When she became the wife of a general board member, she was present. When she became the wife of the presiding bishop of our great and vast church, she was always present. When she became a widow, and the burden of duty would have been less, she continued to be present. And in each of those sessions afterwards, she would pay me a kindly telephone call and give me the grade for the General Assembly and its leadership. I will never forget her report card. There's never going to be, we might as well just come to terms with this. There will never be another Louise Dowdy Patterson in a class. I said in a class all by herself. I mean, she knew how to be friendly, she knew how to be formal, she knew her role, she knew her image, she was always so very authentic. She was not only a wife, she was a missionary, a teacher, an evangelist, a prophetess. She had her own distinct spirituality. And though she was the mark of holy femininity, she never flaunted it as sensuousness, but always as a queen, as a priestess, as a daughter in Zion, and as a mother in Israel. You might say she redefined the role and image of First Lady in the Holiness Church. I want to thank God for sending her our way. As a son of the church, you get a chance to see a lot of things up close. And along with many of you, we've observed every First Lady of the General Church, from Mother Mason to Mother Jones, to Mother Patterson, to Mother Ford, to Mother Owens. All preceded her, but there will never be one like this First Lady of the church. Let me end by reminding you of what Malachi said in chapter 3 and 17. He shall be mine, saith the Lord. Not only is she a unique First Lady, every one of you follow in her pattern as unique. God in his grace never made two snowflakes the same. There are no two grains of sand that are the same. You can put a raindrop on the microscope and no two raindrops are the same. No two stars in the galaxy are the same. No two eye corneas, no two voice prints, no two fingerprints are the same. They know whose baby it is because no two DNA markers are the same. But when he comes, he's gonna see a whole lot of jewels. But when he comes to make up his jewels, they shall be mine. And on behalf of the General Assembly, may I just give God the praise that he's already come, and at least one of his jewels he has taken with him. But when he returns again to make up all of his jewels, only one Mother Louise Patterson, but we will join her and all the saints of the ages in witnessing, they shall be mine, saith the Lord. God bless you.
To our presiding bishop and general board and all of these great leaders, host pastor of this beautiful church, did a great job last night. Say amen for Bishop Hawkins, amen. Bishop Thuston, the general board members told me to tell you that apparently minutes are longer than the General Assembly. There's so much, and I have a resolution for you, but there's so much that I could say as a member of the Porter family to the Patterson family. Of course, my wife and my mother, my sister were so endeared to Lady Louise. She, along with Mother Kelly, I enjoyed you last night, Mother Kelly. I was watching online. You were beautiful. Amen, somebody. You said everything right. The thing that I really appreciate about Mother Kelly and Lady Louise, Evangelist Louise, is their candor, transparency. Whenever they would speak, in the many times before I moved to Memphis, I would have them come to Jackson to impart to the ladies there. They show the women that you can still be human and strive for excellence. You told us something, Mother Kelly, last night about a tub in the floor when the refrigerator for Bishop Patterson and Mother Louise went out and they put ice in there and put their food in there. Sometimes we assume that people have always had wherewithal. But how many know life is a process? Amen? So don't hate on success because you don't know how far people have come. Amen, somebody. Thank you for sharing that with us. Church of God in Christ, Incorporated, Memphis, Tennessee, from the chambers of the General Board to the family of Evangelist Louise Patterson, Louise Dowdy Patterson, who can find a virtuous woman, for her price is far above rubies. Whereas, in accordance to his tender mercies, God, who in his infinite wisdom has seen fit to remove from our midst this jewel of Memphis, Tennessee, and the Church of God in Christ, the Evangelist Louise Dowdy Patterson. We, the presiding bishop and members of the General Board, feel that it is befitting that we express our sympathy and love to the family as we bow our heads to the sovereign will and commend you to him who knoweth best and doeth all things well. The heart of her husband does safely trust in her, so that she shall have no need of spoil. Whereas we pause to give glorious recognition to the blessed marital union for four decades that Evangelist Louise Dowdy Patterson shared with our esteemed former presiding bishop, the late Bishop Gilbert Earl Patterson, having always exhibited the true model of godly marriage and ministry partnership, and served Bishop Patterson until he received his eternal reward. She considers a field and buys it with the fruit of her hands. She plants a vineyard. Whereas we celebrate the life of this entrepreneur of excellence, who through her business acumen continued the legacy of the Bountiful Blessings Ministry, founded in 1967, carrying the baton of the gospel ministry of Bishop G.E. Patterson, reaching and touching the lives of millions around the world. She stretches out her hand to the poor. Yes, she reaches forth her hand to the needy. Whereas now we commemorate the altruistic, philanthropic spirit of Evangelist Louise Dowdy Patterson, displayed not only as the community leader and servant, but as the First Lady and effervescent fragrance of the Temple of Deliverance Church of God in Christ for more than 3 decades. The First Lady of the Tennessee 4th Jurisdiction, Ecclesiastical Jurisdiction, for 12 years, and as the First Lady of the Church of God in Christ for 7 years, who unselfishly gave of her time, talents, and treasures as she continued to impact the lives of people from all walks of life, never seeking recognition or accolades, just desiring to lend a helping hand, as she displayed the love of Jesus Christ and soul sagaciously and freely poured wisdom, truth, prudence, and children whose lives she touched. Therefore, be it resolved of and the members of the Presidium, the General Board of the Church of God in Christ, express our heartfelt and offer prayers and unyielding support to the Dowdy Patterson family, the staff of the Bountiful Blessings Ministry, Bishop Milton Hawkins and the Temple of Deliverance Church family, and to Bishop Jerry L. Maynard and the Tennessee 4th Ecclesiastical Jurisdiction. Be it further resolved that we will honor, remember, memorialize this woman of winsome charm and grace, and continually look back with pride and gratitude for her example. Be it finally resolved that a copy of this resolution will be given to the family of Evangelist Louise Dowdy Patterson, and a copy will be stored in the archives of the General Board's chambers, submitted in humility and love on this second day of December, in the year of our Lord, 2022. His Grace, the Most Reverend John Drew Sheard, presiding Bishop and Chief Apostle, 8th in succession, yours truly, the Right Reverend Brandon B. Porter, Secretary of General Board.
Those of you that believe the words of Isaiah, when he says, they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings of an eagle. They shall run and not be weary, and they shall walk and not faint. If you believe those words, will you put your hands together and thank God that His word is true? It will never fail. We give deference today to our presiding bishop and honor and respect to the members of the presiding board and the general board, and to all of our leadership of the Church of God in Christ. It is my duty today to represent the general church, but I've also been asked to recognize some of the hundreds, Mother, hundreds, Sister Kay, hundreds of resolutions and tributes that you have received from across the country. I will speak as quickly as I can in the 2 minutes that I have. President Joseph and Dr. Jill Biden, former President Barack and Lady Michelle Obama, former President Bill and Lady Hillary Clinton, U.S. Senator Marshall Blackburn, U.S. Senator Bill Hagerty, Governor Bill Lee, Bishops T.D. Jakes, Joseph Walker, Dow Woodson, Marvin Winans, Marvin Timus, David Copeland, and David Talley, and the organizations that they represent. From the city of Memphis, Shelby County, they're somewhere. All right. Shelby County Sheriff's Department, Floyd Bonner, Jr. Tennessee 4th Jurisdiction, all departments of the Church of God in Christ, all elected and appointed officers. Resolutions from Bishop Charles and Lady May Blake, Bishop J. Drew Sheard and Lady Karen Sheard. The Board of Bishops, as well as what you see standing before you are two. One is from Shelby County Board of Commissioners and the Memphis City Council. We cannot read them, they are for detailed. The last one that will be read in summary will be from the Church of God in Christ, which we just say to you, family, that the Church of God in Christ loves you, that Mother Louise Patterson will be memorialized as a favorite daughter of the Church of God in Christ. Her diligence to duty, her deference to quiet dignity accompanied with radiant beauty will forever stand as a standard of excellence in holiness for women everywhere. Therefore, be it finally resolved that the leadership and the constituency of the Church of God in Christ and all who have been represented will continue to pray for the Dowdy Patterson family and the legacy and the memory of Mother Louise, Lady Lou, we shall be honored and cherished forever. It is signed by the presiding bishop and the general secretary of the Church of God in Christ. Dowdy Patterson family, the Church of God in Christ loves you, and you're going to hear them a rousing applause for Lady Lou now. Let Church of God in Christ members, will you just bless the Lord for Lady Louise Patterson? God bless you. Everyone has taken a personal privilege. I will take mine also. Many of you have complimented me on the fact that I've lost weight. That's because Lady Louise Patterson told me I was fat. Please forgive me as I take my leave. One of my mothers in the gospel has also passed away, and I must be in Baltimore by 7 o'clock tonight. God bless you.
Bishop Sheard, let me thank you for allowing me to share in this program in this manner. It's been an honor and a privilege, and again, I want to thank you. We appreciate you all, and we're looking forward now to the Word of God from our presiding bishop, who's going to bless us. As a matter of fact, he will be presented to us
by the Right Reverend Michael E. Hill, Sr., Assistant Secretary of the General Board, Detroit, Michigan.
Pines and to the family, we are praying for you. It is said that if you really want to know something about a person, you should follow them home. Will you just for a few minutes walk with me to the city of Detroit, Michigan, where we see a young man take a church of 8 members and $80 in the bank on a street called Sturtevant in a little city called Highland Park. And with the help of God and with his lovely wife by his side, grow it to where it is now the largest Church of God in Christ congregation in the state of Michigan. Walk with me as he works hard at Wayne State University to earn, not honorary, earn 2 degrees, 1 in mathematics. Walk with me as corporate America is drawn to him. Waste management, gentleman in Chicago by the name of Willie Wilson, gives him, and I want you to hear this, gives him, not Greater Emmanuel, not the church, but gives him $125,000. He takes $120,000 of that and gives it to the area pastors in the city of Detroit. That same Willie Wilson comes to the bishop's conference, and I was there, and he said, "This is for you, Bishop Shear. Do what you want to do with it." And he takes that $100,000 and gives it to the Church of God in Christ. Walk with me. If you really want to know about a man, a landowner, property owner, a builder of people, I walked with him when he was a youth president, and I watched him when service was over, instead of going out of the back door, getting in his vehicle, walk through the young people and take pictures with them. He was touchable. I watched him go over to the activity center and take his jacket off and shoot free throws with the young people. Just walk with me so you can find out who we have as a leader. He's bishop, he's pastor, he's husband, he's father, he's grandfather, he's a friend, and he's a brother. Yes, sir. And today, after we hear the sermonic selection, he is going to come and give a word of comfort to not only the bereaved family, but to all of us that are touched by the life of Mother Louise Patterson. After the choir has finished their selection, all but the family, will you stand and receive our chief apostle, the presiding bishop of the Church of God in Christ, the Bishop J. Drew Shear.
Oh, You can give him more praise than that. Let the words of my mouth, the meditation of my heart, be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. And the people of the Lord said, amen. Please be seated in the presence of the Lord. God bless our general board who are serving with us on today, Bishop Porter, Bishop Hill, Bishop Bryant, Bishop Hall, Bishop Hines, thank you for carrying this service in such a tremendous way. Bishop Colby and Bishop McClellan and Bishop Elijah Hankerson. We certainly praise God for this family. Our dear Sister Kay, we're praying for you. Our dear Mother Kelly, we love you so much. Brother Ronnie, we love you as well. We're praying for the whole family. God bless Bishop Milton Hawkins, the pastor of this church, and First Lady Hawkins. God bless our board of bishops is here with his chairman, Bishop Galbraith, Chairman Thuston, all of the pastors. God bless our general supervisor of the women's department. God bless Mother Barbara McCoo Lewis. We love you, Mother. To my darling wife, I'm so thankful for her, and she accompanies me on today, the beautiful evangelist Karen Clark Shear. To all of the supervisors, all of the first ladies, all of the evangelists, all of the saints and friends, and I'm so thankful to be here to share with you as we celebrate the life of this great woman of God, Mother Louise Patterson. I have a special place in my heart for her because when I was in trouble, she came to my rescue. You ought not to forget people who help you get where you are. She said to me, she said, Drew, come here. She said, shut up. I said, Mother, I ain't said nothing. She said, make sure you ain't saying nothing. Just shut up. When people look at you to say something, you walk the other way. I said, I got you. I got you. She saved my life. Amen. And so Mother Louise Patterson was not only a friend to me, a mother to me, and we talked on a regular basis. One time, shortly after Bishop had gone on to be with the Lord, Brother Achan and I went to lunch with Mother, and we were talking, we were having a good time, and I said, Mother, I said, well, when you gonna get a new car? She said, ain't nothing wrong with my car, Drew. What y'all talking about? Ain't nothing wrong with me and Achan teamed up on her. Say, Mother, you a queen. She was driving that Cadillac. It was pretty, but it wasn't a queen's car. I say, Mother, you got to get you a Mercedes. She said, oh, no, I ain't spending that kind of money on no car. She just, and we talked and we talked and we talked, and a couple of weeks later she called and she said, boy, you made me buy a new car. Mother had class. She was a classy lady, and we praise God for her. Listen, if you'll pray with me for just a few minutes, I promise, I know what time it is, but if you'll pray with me for just a few minutes, I promise to be out of your way. There is a scripture, and it's found in the book of Hebrews. And it's the 11th chapter, the 16th verse. I thank God for all of these ecumenical bishops and to all of you, the people of the Lord. If you'll be so kind, accept the family to stand in reverence to the word of God. It reads thusly, but now they desire a better country, that is an heavenly. Wherefore God is not ashamed to be called their God, for he hath prepared for them a city. Say with me, but now they desire a better country. I'm going to talk to you for the next few fleeting moments from the subject, a better place, a better place. Please be seated in the Lord's presence. Allow me to open this brief dissertation by stating that in 1999, a six-year-old Cuban boy by the name of Elian Gonzalez was a part of a group of 14 refugees who boarded a 17-foot boat leaving Cuba, headed to the United States. He, along with his mother and other family members, took sail on that little boat in pursuit of a better country. I'm told that many of them thought it was a dangerous voyage, but they stayed on that little boat because they desired a better place. Of course, all of them lost their lives except little Elian, but the losing of their lives must be noted as a pursuit of a better country. In our chapter of consideration, the apostle, having referred to the heroic faith and holy lives of several of the Old Testament saints, then pronounces the manner in which they finished their earthly course. He said, "These all died in faith." This had been their mode of life. They lived by faith, and when they came to the close of their lives, still they had not received the promise, neither the entire possession of Canaan, nor the promised Messiah, but they were unshaken in their belief, even in death. As the troubles of life could not move them from the foundation on which they rested, neither could the dreary waters of death. For the Bible inextricably says they died in faith. As to the influence of faith on the general tenor of spirit and conversation, it is said that they considered themselves strangers. For had they sought to return to their native land, the country of Mesopotamia, they could have perhaps easily done so. But they preferred being strangers and pilgrims because they desired a better place. And so we as saints live in a world in which we are not comfortable, for our faith leads us to realize that there has to be something better than this. My brothers and sisters, when you look at our present world, we note that it has been defaced and marred by sin. Sin has converted the world into the region of woe and the shadow of death. So there has to be something better than this. Morning by morning, day by day, evening by evening, night by night, we're faced with the results of a sin-cursed world. Our financial institutions are insecure. Our educational system is failing our young. Our medical systems have very few answers for the maladies of our bodies. Surely, there has to be something better than this. We're faced with police brutality, racial injustice, and certain rise of inequity among our people. We're failing our young, mistreating our seniors, and have simply said to those in between, get it the best way you can. There must be something better than this. Our water is polluted. Our clouds are infested with unquestionable germs. Sickness is in all the land. For sickness, my brothers and sisters, is the fruit of sin. Pain is the offspring of iniquity. And I don't care who you are, you can't get away from sickness. This place in which we live is plagued with diseases. We are constantly affected by the pain of losing our loved ones to the unsolved dilemmas of life. There must be a better place than this. If we look outside the church, you will find that there is an ungodly world, hating God and hating his people, persecuting, bitter, malignant tongues, devouring spirits, ravenous as wild beasts, hateful and hating as demons. In this world, we're lied on, mistreated, buked, and scorned. In this world, we're talked about as sure as you're born. In this world, people are leery of each other. They prejudge you and make assumptions with no validity. There must be a better place than this. Here we are often distressed through the infirmities of our fellow men. One is possessed of an uninformed understanding, another an unsound judgment, a third a stubborn disposition, a fourth a hayward or hasty temper, and in many cases we're all offended. And sometimes this world causes me to become perplexed due to the people I come in contact with. In this world we feel unsafe. We're attempted to lock the criminals out, but we've locked ourselves in. We put locks on the locks and alarm systems on the alarm system. Church, there must be a better place than this. Well, I've got to close here. But they tell me of a place where there is not one envious person. They tell me of a place where not a detractor or evil speaker, not one person with an evil heart or an evil tongue. They tell me of a place where liars and backbiters biters and haters can't get in. They tell me of a place where the streams are pure and the cloud is the sky is cloudless and radiant. They tell me of a place where the air is unpregnated with pollution and holiness spreads throughout its borders. Excuse me, but it sounds like a better place than this. They tell me that it's a healthful place, for I've been told that there are trees where the leaves are good for the healing of the nation. I've been told that the atmosphere is untainted by human offenses. They tell me that diseases and viruses can't get in. They say that the air is salubrious, the enjoyments without peril, and the food incorruptible. Say what you will, but it sounds like a better place. Place than this. However, I hear of those who are trying to make this place where we live better than it is. And I don't find fault with that, but I want to warn the saints what the apostle said in the 15th chapter of 1 Corinthians in the 9th verse. He said, if in this life only we have hope in Christ, we are of all men most miserable. And Jesus said in the 14th chapter of John, in the first 3 verses, let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in me, believe also in God. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. But I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. The apostle Paul picked it up in the 4th chapter of Hebrews in the 9th verse and said, therefore, a time of rest and worship exists for the people of God. So therefore, I believe, I'm convinced, I have no doubt that there is a better place. And I came by to tell you, don't worry about Mother Patterson. She's gone to that better place. She did her part here on earth. She was a good soldier. She made plans to go to a better place. And church, it's good to know that there is a better place than this. Because sometimes we're baffled by what we see in this life, and we often coincide with the songwriter who said trials dark on every hand, and we cannot understand all the ways that God would lead us to that blessed promised land. But he guides us with his eye, and we'll follow till we die, and we'll understand it better by and by when the morning comes. When all the saints of God are gathered home, we'll tell the story how we've overcome, and we'll understand it better by and by. Church, I'm closing here. But my resting place is not this world. But I got a better place. I got a home over in Beulah land. And I realize that the sea of life can become tumultuous. The ship may be tossed and driven, but I've come to encourage you to stay on board. Trials may come, sickness may come, difficulties may erupt, and others may say, give up, but look at your neighbor and say, stay on board, because there is a better place. For we know that if our earthly house of this tabernacle were dissolved, thank God, I got another building, a building that man's hands couldn't make. I've got a better place, a place in a gated community where the streets are paved with gold. Saints, this world is not our home, but they tell me of a place where there's no more crying. For Jesus promised to wipe all tears from our eyes. All sickness will be gone. That's why every day I'm packing up. I'm making sure that every I is dotted. Every T is crossed. Hypocrites can't stop me. Slander can't prohibit me. And backed by backbiters won't stop me. Look at your neighbor and say, I got a better place. My heart is fixed and my mind is made up. The storms may rise, the winds may blow, the hellhounds may come after me, and the haters may hate on me, but no matter how bad things are, tell your neighbor, stay on board. Don't let sickness deter you, for I heard Paul said that I reckon that the sufferings of this present time, they are not worthy to be compared with the glory that shall be revealed in us. Tell your neighbor, hang in there, because weeping may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning. I'm on my way to a better place, a place where the wicked shall cease from troubling, and the weary shall be at rest, and all the saints of the ages shall sit at his feet and be blessed. In that better place, I'm gonna put on my robe and tell the story how I made it over. Get ready, church, because after a while, it'll all be over. After a while, the sun is gonna shine. Tell your neighbor, hang in there, and let's go to the better place. No more crying, no more dying, but shouting and praising him. Say, somebody give God some praise. Look at your neighbor and say, you can shout now, because you know in the end you're going to win. Some glad morning, when this life is over, tell somebody, I will. Come on, Brother Atherton, I'm finished. Look at somebody and say, get ready. Hallelujah. Dear Lord, I thank you for how you blessed us and how you made ways for us. Thank you for the life of our dear mother. Thank you, oh God, for how she's touched our lives. We're better because of Louise Patterson. Continue to bless this family. Continue to make ways, and we'll be so careful to give your name the praise. The glory and honor shall be thine. In Jesus' name we pray. Let every heart say, thank God. Amen. Everyone except the family, please stand. For as much as it is pleased Almighty God to take out of this world our deceased Mother Louise Dowdy Patterson, we commit her body to Mother Earth. Earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, looking for the general resurrection in the last day and the life in the world to come through our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose second coming in glorious majesty to judge the world, the earth and the sea shall give up their dead, and the corruptible bodies of those who sleep in him shall be changed and made like him to his own glorious body, according to the working whereby he is able to subdue all things unto himself. Please join me in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen. And I heard a voice from heaven saying unto me, blessed are the dead who die in the Lord from henceforth. Yea, saith the Spirit, that they may rest from their labors, and their works do follow them. Now, may the God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus, the great shepherd of the sheep, by the blood of the eternal Jesus, equip you to do his will, working in you that which is pleasing in his sight, through Jesus Christ, to whom be the glory forever and ever. Amen. Our chief adjutant is here.
We will be going to Memorial Park for the final resting place of Mother Patterson. With the exception of the general board members' wives, I'm going to ask that Mother Bogan would prepare the widowed bishops' wives to be a part of the processional leading us out first, along with those bishops' wives that are present today. Amen. I'm going to ask that you will remain in your seats. If our ushers can please man the aisle, that we will be prepared to go out in just a few moments. Our bishop's wives are coming out at this time. And we're going out this aisle. This aisle. Thank you. Thank you.
Jesus.